This is automated MrBeast Carousel Animation in After Effects.
So first, you need to create a new composition. So right click and select new composition and then name it main comp and click on OK. Now we need to create another comp for all the YouTubers. So right click new composition and then name it YouTubers. Now make sure you're inside the YouTubers composition and then use the rectangle tool at the top to create a rectangle, and you can hold shift while dragging to scale it evenly. And you can also align the rectangle to the center if you want to, and add round edges to the shape if you'd like. Now select the shape layer and then duplicate it by pressing Ctrl and D. Now with the bottom layer selected, press S for scale, and then scale down the rectangle a bit. So you can use the bigger rectangle as a stroke for the YouTubers. Now import the picture of the first YouTuber, and then select it and press S for the scale properties. Then you can also press Shift and P to add the position settings as well. Now scale down the image a bit so it's above the rectangles, and then click on toggle, switches and modes. Now use the track mat, pick whip tool and connect it with the smaller rectangle to use it as a track mat. And now simply adjust the scale and the position of the image layer so it fits well inside the image. Now we need to make this with all the other YouTubers as well, but in a faster manner. So select the current composition and then duplicate it by pressing Ctrl and D. And you need to duplicate the composition until you have enough comps for each YouTuber. And since I have 8 YouTubers, I will need to have 8 comps in total. Now hold shift and then select the second composition. Then go down and hold shift again and select the last one. And then double click to open all of them at the same time. You can now close out of the first composition. And inside the second one, you simply need to delete the original image of the YouTuber and then import the image of the next YouTuber. Then pick whip the track mat of the smaller rectangle and then resize and reposition the image so it fits well. Then close out of the composition and repeat the process with all the other people and compositions. And once you're done with the final person, you can close out of the composition as well. Back in the main comp, you want to shift select all the YouTuber compositions and then drag them into the timeline. Now click on toggle switches and modes, then make all the layers 3D. Then select all the layers and press P for position, and then move them in C space. So to do this, you need to adjust the third position value to around 500, and you can press U to hide the option again. We are now going to control the position of the comps with a null layer. So right click, then new, and then select null object. Now make the null layer a 3D layer as well, and then press R to open the rotation options. Now to space the icons out evenly, you need to select the first composition and then parent it to the null layer using the pick whip tool. Now we need to calculate how much to offset each YouTuber using basic math. So you might need a calculator for this one. Because a full circle is 360 degrees, we need to type in 360 and then divide that number by the amount of YouTubers you have. So in my case, I have 8 YouTubers. So I will type in 8 and then get the answer. The answer is the amount of degrees we need to offset each composition to space them out evenly. So remember this number for later on, and then go back to After Effects. On the null layer, you want to type in the answer of the calculation on the Y rotation value, and then parent the second composition to the null layer to ensure that we lock it in that location. Now to make it easy for us, we can actually do the calculations inside of After Effects. So simply click on the Y rotation value and then type in plus, and then type in the answer of the calculation and then press enter. And After Effects will actually do the calculation for us. Now parent the third comp to the null object and then type in plus and then your number again, and then parent the comp. And then repeat this process with all the compositions. And once complete, you should have all the compositions in a round circle. And if they overlap a bit, like in this case, then you might have to select all the layers and then press S for scale and then scale them down a little bit. And if I move around the camera a bit, you can see exactly what we did. Now make sure you're at the start of the comp and then select the null, and then press R for rotation. You can now set the Y rotation back to whatever start position you want. And you can move between the people by simply typing a plus and then your number. Now to create a carousel animation, keyframe the Y rotation value and then move forward a bit. To pause in between the YouTubers, you need to create the keyframe with the current value. Then move forward again and then type in plus and then your number to move exactly to your next person. Then move forward again and then create a pause keyframe. And then do the plus calculation again to switch to the next person. And you can do this as many times as you want. and this is what we got. You can also move the keyframes around to adjust the timing of the animation. And to make everything smoother, you can select the keyframes and then press F9 to easy ease them. And you can also enable motion blur on all the layers to make it look even better. Now you might notice that you can see the YouTubers in between the gaps. And there's actually an easy way to fix this. Simply right click, new, and then select solid. And then make sure the color is set to black or whatever color you want as a background, and then click on OK. Now drag the solid below all the other layers and then make it a 3D layer as well. And this works because we have already offsetted the compositions and Z space. And you can see it more clearly in this view, where red is the solid and the rest are all the YouTubers. And now we can't see through the gaps anymore. Now to create this dark shadow at the edges of the carousel, you need to select all the layers, then right click and then select pre-compose. And then make sure move all attributes is checked. And you can name it carousel or whatever you like. Now to create the shadow, you need to select the rectangle tool and then make sure to click inside the timeline to deselect everything, so you don't accidentally create a mask. Now click and drag on the screen to create a rectangle on the left side of the picture. And also click on fill and set it to black. To make it actually look like a shadow, you need to go to effects and then search fast box blur. And then apply the effect to the shape. Now in effects and tools, increase the blur radius and play around with the iterations to get a soft shadow on the pictures. And you might as well need to adjust the shape a bit to make it look good. Now to do the same thing on the other side, you can simply select the shape layer and duplicate it by pressing Ctrl and D, and then move it to the other side of the carousel. Now that the shadow is done, we can move on to the last part, which is the box around the carousel and also the transparent background on it. But before that, you need to select the layers and then right click and then select pre-compose again and name it shadow. To create the box around the carousel, you first need to left click on the timeline to deselect everything. Then you can select the rectangle tool and click and drag to make a box around the carousel. To remove the fill color, click on fill and then select none and then click on OK. Now you only need to click on stroke and then choose your desired stroke color and then adjust the stroke width to your liking. And you can also resize the shape if you like. To add round corners, you can click on add on the top and then round corners. Then you can expand the round corners section and then adjust the radius. And to get this MrBeast look on the box, you need to go to effects and search bevel. And then apply the bevel alpha effect to the rectangle. Now in effects and tools, you can increase the edge thickness and play around with the values. Now for the last part, we need to make the background transparent. And you can see that it's not transparent right now by enabling this icon. So to make it transparent, select the rectangle and then duplicate it by pressing Ctrl and D. And then drag it below all the other layers. Now with the layer selected, click on fill. And then make sure the rectangle has any color assigned to it. And it doesn't matter which one. And then click on OK. Then click on stroke and then disable it by selecting none and then click on OK. Now click on toggle switches and modes so you have this menu. And then use the track matte pick whip tool and connect it with the rectangle below. And if you now enable transparency, we can see that the rest is transparent. And you have now created this MrBeast carousel animation. And you can find the project file in the description below.